So I made this lute from a hemlock branch. And I know out here, I think the hemlocks also were having the woolly gilded, and I think that they were bringing to the East Coast the predators that were keeping it under control here because they didn't have that. I live on this road, it's really, it's beautiful, it's forest. Hemlock trees around. You know, we had such a cold winter last year that actually the small ones are surviving because it was so cold. We killed the woolly gilders, and so the hemlocks are a chance now. I'm not sure why I'm bringing this up. And then, so I took this branch. And I just popped holes in it. I just licked my fingers and laid them down on the branch and put holes in it and let it be what it was. It just kind of plays one thing. It's not tuned to anything in particular. Whenever I pick it up, I just feel like it's like this ancient song. It's like I'm playing something that's probably been played in one of these old-timey flutes. Idea of making all these Native American flutes standardized to something. And I used to look at pictures of, you know, people playing these flutes, and I'm like, what kind of fingering is that? Like, nobody does that, you know? But on these flutes, when you just put the holes in them, that's the only way they play. You just like put your fingers where they need to be, and you get sound. When I do that, I always feel like it's like the ancients are speaking. Like, they're always here. I heard once someone asked a question to this fire. It's a sacred fire community. And I don't participate much in it, but I went, I was like, I'm going to check it out. There's a, they have what they call grandfather fire. They say there are like four people who can just carry the energy of that fire and Papawari. So people can go to these fires. And you can watch this man transform. He'll smoke a cigar and they ask for there to be a lot of jokes and laughter and things heat up. You can see he's getting all heated up and then he like transforms. And that's the spirit of fire, you know, use him as a voice and he can ask questions. He's not asking this question around. I don't know how they put it. I remember what the answer was. It had to do with when the Europeans came here and carried all of them. So much death, they're just asking about it. And the fire's answer was, they knew it was happening. And that the people back then decided, like so many of them just saw that there was so much change coming, that they chose to just like all die in mass, like they would just allow that to happen. And that they would take like what they knew in its purity, and in their blood, like, put it in the earth so that we could access it later. And it's just kind of, through all whatever I played, for whatever reason, that's the thing, the ending it is just. But all of the beauty in the world, experience by flying, and then also witnessing the ways in which we impact the world that are not so beautiful. Human beings are still the hands of creation. We still are the ones that have the potential to move stones or plant seeds or nurture life. And just that memory that all of that wisdom for us to access. Maybe just came back when I went out there after being in the air all day and put my feet on the earth outside. Did I just share that because it's what came up? finish with the flute I began with. Completion. It's kind of like all peaceful to that moment. I just feel the agitation, but it's kind of like that good agitation. Like, oh yeah, like, we're here for something. Like Mary Oliver, I'm like, what will you do with my wild and precious life? Amazing. It's an encouragement to always ask yourself that question. It's such a simple one to remember and such a beautiful poem. What will you do with your one wild and precious?